Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you how to make ghee at home. Homemade ghee is very simple to make and it hardly takes 10 to 15 minutes for you to make a fresh batch of homemade ghee. Let's get started. I've taken a heavy bottom pan. Always make sure that you use a heavy bottom pan for making ghee at home because it prevents the ghee from getting burnt in the process of making it. Today I have taken 500 grams of unsalted butter. When you are buying butter from the store, always make sure that it's unsalted butter because all the stores will have both salted and unsalted butter. But we would need to use unsalted butter for making this ghee. So I'm going to open the pack and transfer the butter to the pan. Make sure the heat is at medium. So I have added two blocks of 250 grams of butter now. After adding the butter, we have to wait for the butter to melt completely. So use a ladle and keep mixing it now and then so that it gets melted uniformly and it won't get burnt at the bottom as well. The first step is the butter to melt completely. It's almost melted. So look at the color now. It's just the color of the butter. It's in the melted stage now. So keep stirring it and keep the heat at medium. Very soon you will notice the color changing from this bright yellow to a transparent. So it's almost halfway through. As you notice that the color, the transparency is just started to form. Look at the color now. So it's changing from the bright yellow to transparent, and even if you look now, the size of the bubbles will be a little bit big. So this is when we have to be very careful because we are almost towards the end. Look at the color, it's almost transparent now. As I told you earlier, it has been transformed from the bright yellow to a transparent form, and also the size of the bubbles has become reduced. It's almost like very minute sizes of bubbles. This is when you have to turn off the heat immediately and you have to transfer the ghee to a different container because the pan will have some heat in it, so it will start to burn the ghee. So it's better to transfer it immediately, and the last part, just strain it and extract the ghee, and you have to discard the milk solids. And once it's cooled down, you can transfer it to a glass bottle and you can use it for preparing some sweets or any recipes that require ghee. I feel that homemade ghee always tastes much better than the store-bought ghee. So give it a try at home and share your feedback. And if you like this video and if you wish to watch more such interesting recipes, do subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.